Okay, we're back for episode 3 of the Pozo Training Diaries. And I tell you what, Pozo has sprung to life this week. The wind has returned and there's been some waves. Yeah, boys have been going off. And the girls, yeah, it's been absolutely action-packed. I've had a full week of filming and I have got some absolute gems for you coming up. Obviously, it's just over a week until the World Cup starts. It's the first Wave World Cup of 2019 and excitement is there. We're talking to Pozo, obviously, and we're going to talk about the men to kick things off. Now, Pozo, there is 4 main players. Now, don't get me wrong, there is other guys that can challenge, but there are 4 big guns. They always turn up early and they are always in the mix. Who are they? Well, it's pretty obvious, isn't it? Firstly, we've got Ricardo Campello. Yes, obviously, the crazy man from Venezuela. We've got the Brazilian, Marcílio Brown, pulled up into 2nd place that last year, taking down Victor Fernandez. Obviously, Victor Fernandez is another one of that top 4. He's always been inside the top 2, I think, for 10, 11 years. Last year was the first time he was outside of that top 2. And then we've got last year's champ, Philip Costa, absolute man on a mission. I've done a bit of analysing. Why are these guys the best and how they line up with each other? So let me go through a few of the key moves. Now, in the World Cup, the most jumps you're probably going to see in a heat to count are 3 jumps. So we look at the 3 best jumps. Now, these guys have all got the double. So we don't even look at the double anymore. We look at the stall double, yes. So who's got it? Well, Marcílio Brown, he has definitely got it. Ricardo Campello, he does some absolute massive ones. Victor Fernandez, until this year, hadn't got the stall double, but he has stepped it up. Yeah, absolutely nailing the stall doubles in practice. So Victor Fernandez, that was kind of what was letting him down a little bit last year. Maybe why he dropped outside that top 2. But he looks back and he's back strong. And then we've got Philip Costa. He was probably the first man to be doing full-on controlled stall doubles. And he has still got them in his bag of tricks. Next up, the push forward. Yes, these boys have all got the push forward. Or have they? No, there's one man who is still missing, Victor Fernandez. We've seen him do it in the past, but we don't see him out there practicing. We see Brown. He's out there punishing himself, and he's landing some pretty sweet ones. Ricardo Campello has got this move down. This is his go-to move. This is the one that is getting him through the heats, and he really has that on lock. And then we've got Philip Costa. If you saw the video I posted earlier in the week of 15 years old, he was doing a push forward. 10 years on, yeah, it's got a bit more consistent and it is absolute on point. So Victor Fernandez, that is where he's lacking. How does he pull it back? Well, rumour has it, he has been seen doing tabletop double forwards. Now, can you count a stall double and a tabletop double? Yes, you can. Yes, you can. So that is going to be very interesting. All those guys have 2 really big jumping moves, and that's kind of what sets them apart from the rest. There are a few other guys doing them. I mean, Robbie Swift for one, but again, he hasn't been inside that top 4 for a while now. That's why he's not in at the moment. Obviously, a 3rd jump could come into play, and we're going to see massive back loops. 1 foot, 1 hand, 1 foot, 1 hand. We're going to see big tweaked push loops, and I think we might even see some crazy 1-footed forwards or 1 foot, 1 hand forwards from Ricardo Campello. So that's how the jumping lines up, but the wave moves is really where it's going to go down. So just looking at the wave moves, well, have they got the 360s? Of course they have. They've got all the 360s. All 4 guys pulling them off easily. Goiters. Yeah. All got the goiters as well. But we don't see Ricardo Campello pulling these off as consistently as the other riders. Brazinho, seen him pinging them out all day long. You know, Costa, all day long. Victor Fernandez is his go-to move on the wave. But Ricardo Campello, don't see him do as many. But what we do see Ricardo Campello do is that absolute sick tabletop off the lip. We don't see anybody else doing that. And he is a wrapped right round the mast. It's probably one of my favorite tricks out there. So that is where Campello comes back in. We've also seen Victor Fernandez pull off like a switch stance. I don't even know what you call it. It's not even a switch stance, it's like a clue first. What is it? It's a 360 where he's already flipped the rig. I'll put it on. You can judge for yourself what it is, but it is a little bit different, and that could give the edge when needed. We've also seen the shifty off the lip. Marsilio Brown, Costa have been pulling these off in practice. I don't think I've got any on camera, but trust me, they are pulling them off. Back loop, push loop off the lip. Are we going to see any of them? Mark my words, we will see one of those moves go down in a heat this year. Costa has been pulling him off in the practice. Brown, pull him off in the practice. Have we seen Ricardo or Victor? No, not yet. Well, I haven't anyway. So there are a few moves out there, and we can't forget the double off the lip. Yeah, the double off the lip. Philip Costa, he has been smashing some out in practice. Again, I didn't get him landing one back in, but rumor has it he's been landing a few. Obviously, Brown pulled one off in the final last year. So he has been doing a few as well. Ricardo, we've not seen it. Victor, we've not seen it. Are they capable? Of course they're capable. So that could happen in the heat. And then we've got just the flat out wave riding. You know, these guys, some of them, they've all got different styles. You've got to say Victor Fernandez has just such a smooth riding style and links trick to trick. And that is what has got him through a lot of heats in the past. Ricardo, he's just explosive. Costa, he is a trick master. I think in the final last year, I don't even think he went frontside. He got through without doing it, just doing tricks on the wave. But he has got a mean top turn on him. And then Brown, a very complete wave rider. It's going to be a very interesting year. And I'm not counting out anyone else. I'm not saying these are the top four and they're going to be the top four again. But these definitely have the upper hand at the moment. And they've all been pushing super hard. We're going to go into the other contenders in the next episode, I think. Otherwise, we're going to have too much. We've got to talk about the women as well, because that race has definitely hotted up. You know, a few years ago, we weren't seeing back loops as common, you know, as the top five. Now we're seeing all the top five riders pulling off back loops pretty cleanly. We're seeing nice push loops going down, but the top girls are stepping it up. Tweak push loops, and I'm talking proper tweaked. We're seeing stalled forwards, massive stalled forwards. And now the double is coming into the game. I've not seen any of the girls landing them for a while, but Sarah Keita last week, as I showed you the diaries, is going for them. Dida, we can't count her out. What other moves are we going to see? Well, are we going to come down to the wave moves? Ibaya Moreno, been the world champ for a few years now, and that is where she is the one to beat. She has just got absolute killer style. Saw her land a sick 360 the other day. We've seen her land goiters before. Dida Moreno, we've seen her land 360s and goiters before, and shakers. And then you're thinking, what's Sarah Keita going to do? Well, guess what? She has just stepped up the game. Check this thing.
Oh, sick.
Now that is a 360. You can hear her shouting and screaming from the beach. She was super happy, but no doubt about it, that is a proper 360, and that puts her really in the game. She's got a mean top turn on her. She's got the shaker coming from that freestyle background and maybe shoved the tacker in. So that race for the title is definitely stepped up. Schnaddy and Erpenstein have definitely got a shot of the podium if they can get their game together. So it's going to be super exciting. Like I say, just over a week to go, and it is all hotted up. But this isn't the training diaries if Louis don't put a few features in, is it? So we got a few features, and we're bringing one back. We're bringing this back. Yes, RocketMan, we're bringing it back, because we have seen some absolute sick rockets this week. We've seen some random gyms going for some rockets. We've seen some big players going for rockets. Everybody loves a rocket, but there was one rocket man that can't be denied this week, and it has to be the freestyle world champion, Gorlito Estrado. He has been the rocket man this week. He has just been boosting. He loves a bit of airtime. And I was at the cafe the other day, having a latte, and I saw him creeping up to the rock. And I'm thinking, what's he doing up here? And he was having a look. We were thinking, surely he's not gonna jump the rock. And then he kept eyeing it up, and I was filming. And he was eyeing it up, and he did like a sort of tester. I think like a snake does to a human. Apparently they lie next to a human, see how big it is, see if he can eat it, see if it's the right size. And that's what Gorlito was doing. He was jumping next to the rock to see if he'd make it. Disappointingly, in the end, he didn't go for it. I was gutted because I was for sure the freestyle champ was going to give it a go. I spoke to him yesterday. It's not off the cards. So what's this space? Will we see Gorlito Estrado jump the rock? Let's hope so. Let's hope he doesn't do what I did a couple of years ago when we did the Rockstar Challenge. Yes, anyone who remembers that video. What else have we got? Well, we've got a lot of guys out there, and some of the guys from the beach, I can't tell who they are. So they're kind of like random rippers, and we've had a few random rippers. But this week's random ripper is this guy on the simmer. Yes, he was just pulling off some absolute killer stall forwards. Like, absolutely sick, just perfect style. Every time I looked at him, just perfect style. So we got to give him a shout out for Random Ripper of the Week. Yes, good skills, matey, good skills. We're going to freeze frame his face. Well, it's not the best screenshot I could say, but tag him in the comments below if you do know him. Nice work. And we've got to give this bloke a shout out. This guy is not from the wave sailing capital of Europe or the world, let's say. He's from Israel, yeah. But he has been sending it big time. And you know what? He has got massive balls. Oh, I've got big balls. And they're such big balls. Big balls. Yes, this is Thomas. I can't say the name like they do in Israel. But that's my best accent I can do. But my God, he was sending it. He's got a real sick stall forward on him. I seen him pull off some nice push loops. And then this is how he got the Big Balls Award. He was flying out. It was early morning. It was so windy. He was on a 3.7 and he comes up to this ramp. Jagerstone's behind him and he just sent it. Oh, dude. Yes. Are you kidding? Look at that thing. Yeah, an absolute crazy double from Tommy. I've nicknamed him Dangerous Dave because he is dangerous, no doubt about it. But that was a flipping excellent effort, dude. And that chirped me up behind the camera. And you, my son, have got massive balls. Yeah, what an effort, dude. What an effort. And if you saw, he was using an F2 board. Yes. F2 are back, and guess what? They're gonna give away a board. So if you watched last week's episode, at the very end, we talked about beer money and memberships. If you go to windsurfing.tv/beer money, you can get involved, become a member of Windsurfing TV and be in for the raffle to win a board. There might be a couple of sups up for grabs, and even F2 are doing sales now, and they said they're going to put up a sale as well. So depending, if you remember, you can have a chance to win this. I'll give more information coming up on the channel, but definitely get involved with that because there's going to be some top prizes, maybe some more coming soon. So I think we're going to give away that maybe in about a month, so 1st of August, so you've got time to get involved. Also, what else have we got? We're bringing back features. Yes, we are. Like I said, it's been a busy week here. And we got a phone call. Yeah, we got a phone call from K4 Fins. Now, K4 fins at the moment are taking over the world. The yellow fins, if you haven't noticed them, where have you been? They're popping up everywhere. Top riders are using them. Thomas Traverso, we got Leon Jammer, Adam Lewis, see Mark Paré, so they have been popping up everywhere. So we're gonna bring back, I know what you're thinking, yes, we are bringing it back. We're bringing back.
It's time for spray of the day. Saved it.
Yes, spray of the day is back. Oh, yes. So there you go. Do you like spray of the day? We can do more spray of the day if you like. And another big shout out to K4 Fins. For telling us to bring that back, because it is an epic feature. And heads up to Adam Lewis, Mark Perry for a bit of sound effects there. Absolute classic, boys. And obviously, if you want to buy K4 fins, guess where they sell them? Yes, Pozo wins. Obviously, the best shop in Pozo has them. You can get K4 fins. You can hire your gear from there. They sort your accommodation. They do the car hire. They do pretty much everything. So a massive big up again to Pozo wins for supporting the Diaries. It's a worthy cause this time of year. But there we go. That's it. I've got to leave you with one thing, because I've talked about a lot of big guns in this episode. But a couple of massive guns just turned up. Yes, Pepe Cruz is here. Liam Shrunkabeck Dunkabeck is here. Jaden Tiger. The youths are in town. The juniors are taking Pozo by storm. It is absolutely rammed out there. And the boys are going off. I'm just going to give you a little glimpse into that, because we're going to do a full junior episode pretty soon. But Liam Shrunkabeck Dunkabeck got a few tips for a bit of action this week, and he has been pinging out the back loops, massive back loops all day long. Jaden Tiger, his training partner, has been doing the push loops, and I mean sick push loops, absolutely crazy. He's even been giving Liam some tips. Like, these juniors, they just work in a different way. They're helping each other. And then Liam went out and obviously busted out his first push loops. Yes, high five. That was impressive. Then rocked out like three in a row or something. And Jaden was still giving him tips as we're going on. So the boys are just going off. There's so many to talk about. Like I said, we're going to do more of a feature on them coming up. But everyone on the water this week has been going crazy. And there has definitely been some painful wipeouts. So I'm going to leave you with a new feature, which we're calling...
Why are you crying?
Why are you crying? Yes, it's a great name, and we've got a meme to go with it. We're going to work on this, but standout crashes for me have to be Robbie Swift. The double push loop into face plant.
Why are you crying?
Oh, yes, that looks painful. And that's why Robbie Swift is crying. We saw Mark Paré come to a similar fate. Yes, wants the push loop forward. He's been working hard on it. He came down super hard on this one. And he had a strange twitch on his face when he came in. He didn't look well. He had a headache for a couple of days.
Okay.
So that didn't look good. And then I got sent these beauties this morning. This one from Lucas Meldrum from the UK. Now, this is not how you want a back loop. Yes, exactly. That's a painful one. And then for me, one of my favourites I've been sent is this double effort from Mr. Smooth. Yes, check this This is just the classic running man if ever you've seen it. Oh my God. That is winded if I've ever seen it. And that is why they're crying, boys and girls. So there we go. That is it for another training diaries. It's a monster. Stay tuned for episode 4. We're going to try and squeeze in a send it Sunday as well. I'm going to be busy. Yes, I'm going to be busy. And stay tuned to the end for a little bit more details on the competition. Become a member. I think we've got 15,000 subscribers now. It just went over the limit of 15,000. We had about 20 join the members, Windsurfing TV members. We've also the beer money, I should say, the guys who have already paid the beer money this year are also members, so you don't have to pay again. Don't worry, if you've paid in 2019, I appreciate the support. That is what's keeping the channel going. Keep it up, and I tell you, there will be prizes. I've said that so many times, but there will be, honestly. They're massive, they're gonna be huge. So see you next time. Okay, so that is it for another episode. Like I said, join the members club. Yes, you can click up here to join the Windsurfing Team members. We got 15,000 subscribers. We got about 20 members. Come on, we need a few more. I thought we might get a few more. You can win an F2 board of your choice, depending what's in stock. But when they're in stock, you can have what you want. Apparently, a sale might be up for grabs. A couple of subs. They're all getting drawn within a month. So you have to join within the month. All the details will be on the site. And click over here for last week's episode. Subscribe and give us a thumbs up, like.